Hey, what's up? This is DL from Bad Wolves, and you're listening to Total Rock.
Aura of Total Rock, and today I have the pleasure of meeting DL of Bad Wolves, welcoming us to the European capitals of the arenas. Welcome, how are you doing today?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm very good, I'm very excited. It's the first time that I'm seeing you. I've seen you actually with the Akashi train a few years ago, but this is a bit different.
A little bit.
It's technically your first run with Bad Wolves. The album was released last year, but just a couple of weeks ago, we've released the deluxe version with a few very special, intimate versions. There's one cover of Ozzy Osbourne's Mama, I'm Coming Home.
Correct.
What was the best part about the last year and a half coming out of Corona lockdown into a new album, new tour, new everything, a new you?
Yeah, that's probably the best part. Yeah, just the excitement of the unknown and... getting back into the touring game. You know, I toured with Acacia Strain for a long time, and this now, actually the Volbeat tour, is my third tour with Bad Wolves. Okay. So actually, you know, it's been kind of a weird record cycle in terms of releasing the album and not being able to tour on it right away because there was some legal stuff with the band that had to get sorted out, and 20 other things. So, you know, amongst all of that stuff, it was kind of a weird release, but you know, after we got over those humps and everything, it's just been kind of nonstop on the road since then. So, but it's really good. The shows are amazing. We're blessed with the opportunity to play with amazing bands on amazing tours in front of a ton of people. So I don't think it gets better than that, honestly. Yeah.
And how does it feel to play an Ozzy Osbourne cover about coming home, about also it touches on emotional repair that I'm guessing also the band related to some extent. So how come that one was picked? And no, I know you're a big fan of Michael Jackson, so how come you didn't do a Michael Jackson cover?
That never say never, right? Yeah. So, you know, the Mama, I'm Coming Home covers, I think all of us, we all agreed on it because first and foremost, obviously, we're Ozzy Osbourne fans, and I think anybody that plays rock or metal this day and age can owe some sort of tip of the hat to Ozzy and what he's done. So that was kind of a no-brainer when we had like a list to pick out of and everything. But beyond that, personally to me, it's you know, it's special. I have a wife and children, and being renewed, refreshed into the touring game and everything. It's definitely special to me because it's a song of being away in any regard, whether you're in the military or on tour or whatever the case may be. Being away from loved ones is never easy, and I'm learning that too, especially on a tour like this. It's 2.5 months long, and we're barely a month into it, and I really miss my family and my wife and stuff. So yeah, it's very special to me, and it shines a light on that, being away from loved ones. Yeah.
So can we expect a Michael Jackson cover? You said never say never, but there's a twinkle in your eye when you said that. Is there a deluxe version?
Yeah, you never know. With Better Noise and Bad Wolves, you never fucking know. It might come out tomorrow. Yeah, we actually, it's funny, we were just talking about Michael Jackson. We were all listening to it.
We all do. All
Yeah. So you never know, man. We love doing covers. It's a really fun thing to do for a band like us, where it just, we get to take a song that we love and a song that may not have been put under the spotlight in front of young fans like fans that we have, and you can kind of breathe life into an old song and put your own spin on it, and that's just really fun for us. So yeah,
that's great. I'm looking forward to maybe enjoying it on stage. Are you doing it on stage? I know you're doing the Mama zombie cover.
We are not currently playing Mama just because we came out it was we recorded it in a very different fashion as to what we're used to. We recorded it on the road on the last tour that we were on. We just set up a studio in the hotel, and we recorded it all together in collaboration as a collaborative effort. And so that the timing of everything, it didn't allow us to rehearse it for this tour, but we will be playing it probably on the next tour or whatever shows we play. But Right now, you're going to be graced with a zombie. For sure.
Look forward to that. Another thing that I really enjoy with the deluxe version is two collaborations. There's one with Spencer of Ice Nine Kills.
Yep.
That was also on the EP before the deluxe version. And also a new one with Aaron of Mice and Men.
Mm-hmm.
How did that come to be? Was it also remote, or did you actually have a party in the studio together?
I believe the Ice Nine Kills feature was done separately. They had the track and they sorted it because they had their own studio, and as well as the Aaron one. You know, everybody kind of, in this world now, everybody almost records their own stuff.
As a fan, I still want to think about a party in the studio, two bands coming together.
There was a huge fucking party. And there was, we were popping bottles and we started a fire and the whole fucking place burnt down.
I appreciate that.
So there you go.
Even though I know it didn't happen, I still have that image and I appreciate it.
Yeah, yeah. We're not that cool.
What about, I've seen a few interviews that kind of collided two versions of you. I think one of them was the beginning of lockdown that you said that you kind of enjoying being at home. And then the more recent one that said that you miss people so much. So it kind of contradicted my image of a rock star just being on the road, just mesmerizing people on stage and then wanting to go back home to recharge. So that extrovert, introvert, where are you actually in between? Or is it maybe it's just a cycle that you go back and forth?
Yeah, I think, you know, really at the end of the day, I am very introverted. I love my alone time. I love being with my family. I love my privacy. But, you know, this being my third tour with the band and getting out more again and getting back into the rhythm, playing live music and stuff, that it did really reignite a hunger and an interest to connect with fans, meet guys like you, you know, do these interviews, talk to people. And I have a newfound appreciation for that stuff. But really, at the end of the day, I love my privacy and I am a homebody. So you can revert to the first answer. I'm an introvert for sure.
And I've seen a rumor online that is backed on some facts. I think this is the first project that you don't play the guitar. So there's no guitar first time.
Yeah, yeah.
So there's a rumor online that you're still adjusting to what to do with your hands while on stage. So is that true? Have you caught yourself just with your hands in the air, not really sure what happened?
Maybe on the first tour, okay. It was kind of weird for me. But, you know, now I think we've all kind of fell into a groove and know our place. And I'm very comfortable on stage. The first two tours, maybe the first tour and a half, I was pretty goddamn nervous, honestly. You know, I mean, who wouldn't be stepping into this role? But, you know, now it's just we're all very comfortable with each other. We all know what to expect out of each other on stage. And, it's kind of a different ballgame at this point. And, you know, I've had a year to let it kind of simmer. And I still don't know what to do with my hands. So I just stick them in my goddamn pocket.
So do you make sure to always go on stage with pockets?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Something in my hand. Hold a towel. Hold the mic. You know, put something in your hand. Yeah.
Okay. That's great.
Yeah. But all jokes aside, yeah, it's fine. It's comfortable now. Yeah.
I'm going to try and go a bit personal, get some your views on something that I'm guessing we all experienced over the last 2 years. We had too much free time,
mm-hmm.
too many collision of opinions. It doesn't matter what you believe in, whether it's football, corona, politics, whatever. We all had two opinions on anything. And obviously the band went through, as you said, the legal battle, and a lot of opinions were voiced about things regarding the band. Did it affect your way of using the internet, ever holding yourself more or voicing your opinion a bit more, getting more into arguments online or less, reading more opinions, change any of your ways of using the online information?
Yes and no, I guess. You know, just coming into the band with all of that stuff going on, it just got so loud and, you know, unfortunately kind of messy online. And none of us really subscribe to any of that stuff. You know, I don't dabble in politics. I don't.
Do you ever find yourself just biting your tongue? Because it's really easy to just say something thinking you're going to shut someone up, and then you just get into that phoning battle.
Not really, yeah, because just knowing that, it's like you're just trying to win an unwinnable battle. Like, you're just going to fight forever online with somebody that doesn't know you and you don't know them, and it's just like just throwing dirt. What's the point of that? You know, it's I don't have fucking time for that, honestly. Like I said, I have two kids, a family, I have more important fish to fry. And it's just like, I appreciate the internet. I appreciate social media. You know, it's a tool. It's very valuable. It's helped smaller bands become bigger bands, put you in front of a totally different audience. It's a totally different way of living, thinking. Do I like social media and the internet? Fuck no. You know, I think I was part of that last generation of like bridging that gap between my parents who don't fuck with the internet at all and like my kids who that's all they only know, you know? So it's just like, yeah, I'm still getting used to it. I don't, I'm sure, you know, fans and, you know, even you were like, you know, don't see me online too much. And there's a reason for that. We've talked about, I'm kind of introverted, but, more importantly, I feel like, you know, if you are going to spend your time and energy doing something on social media, it should be quality and worthwhile, and it should be important and not just these like, I'm fucking crazy guy skit and all this stuff. Like, you know, it's just, so yeah.
Do you still own a VHS cassette player?
No.
No, okay.
So but I have a lot of VHSs that I can't fucking do anything with.
Yeah. Love that. I want to confront you with one last weird, it's not a rumor, it's like a perception of metal people. We just had a really lovely chat, even though you swore a lot, but I challenge you to that. But yeah, you all have kids, and I've seen some interviews with the rest of them, and you all seem really lovely people, but for some reason, metal still produces those promo pics with angry faces, like, don't talk to us, we've just slaughtered some poor animals, or, I don't know, pillaged the village, or anything like that. Why is that still a thing? Why do we not see promo pics with smiles and unicorns?
Well, I don't know the right answer to that, to be honest with you.
But are you up for the change?
I think we have plenty of... I just don't think that they've been... If we had our pick, we would have used the ones that had smiles in them, but that's not usually our pick. So we do have pictures of us smiling. Okay. Trust me, we're not that miserable. So
the challenge is out there. Just presented the next tour, the next album, promo pics with the kids, just smiles and maybe tiara.
Yeah, licking lollipops. Just
I love that.
Yeah.
I'll be front row for that.
Cool.
Okay, DL, we said the Dear Monsters Deluxe version is out now. So many great sounds. You promised us also a cover of Michael Jackson. Maybe.
I promised it?
Oh, did not? Okay, I'll edit it so you did. Okay. You're on tour with Fullbeat and Skindred. I'm hoping for more stuff. What else do we need to know about the future of the band that you want to say to listeners before we say goodbye?
Definitely just catch us on the rest of the Volbeat tour and keep your ear to the ground because we are diligently working on a new album right now. Hopefully, you know, don't hold me to this, but hopefully to be put out in the summer, maybe early fall of next year. So, but we do have at least two albums worth of material right now. So always working, man. We're always writing and we're always excited. And, also just check out My Mom Coming Home. Cause that's fresh and you can dig into that now. So
I confirm. It's a great deal of Bad Wolves. Thank you much for your time. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.